Next concept is dimensions of capacity. Dimensions of capacity. How to write the dimensional formula of a physical quantity? First, write the general formula. C is equal to Q by V. We can write Q is equal to IT by V is equal to W by Q. This Q will go up. Therefore, IT Q by W is equal to C. What is I? Current, T, time, Q, charge, work, joules. So, what is the dimensional formula of the capacitor? I, A, time symbol is capital T, charge symbol, again it is IT, therefore AT by work ML square T power minus 2, A square T square by ML square T power minus 2. If you write in the perfect order, M power 1, L power minus 2, this T power minus 2 goes up, T power 4, A power 2. This is the dimensional symbol of capacitance. M power minus 1, L power minus 2, T power 4, A power 2. So capacitance has dimensions of minus 1 in mass, minus 2 in length, plus 4 in time, and 2 in current. Cut. Capacity is a scalar quantity. Now we will see the dependence and independence of other physical quantities with respect to the capacitance. Capacity is a scalar quantity. Capacity depends upon there are some factors where the capacity depends. What are those factors? First one, capacitor has two plates. The capacity of a capacitor depends upon the total surface area of the conducting plates. That is the first property. Total surface area of conducting plates. Next, it depends upon the gap between the plates. Between the conducting plates. We will see how these are dependent in the capacitance. We will see in the expressions. Third one, it depends upon the dielectric constant of the medium. Upon dielectric constant of the medium. Last one, which is very, very important, presence of another medium near to the surrounding region. Presence of another medium which is nearby. These are the four things which are the depends upon the capacity. See, first one, total surface area of the conducting plates. Second one, gap between the conducting plates. How the gap is relative to the capacity of the capacitance, we will see. Next, depends upon the dielectric constant of the medium. Next, presence of the another medium which is nearby to the conductor. There are some factors which is independent of capacity also. We are going to see that. Now we are going to see the capacity independence on capacity independent on here also four factors where the capacity is independent. In the definition of capacitor, one term is very, very important. Whatever may be the shape and size of the plates means capacitance is independent of shape of the material and quality of the nature of the material. See, first one, shape of the material. Second one, nature of the material. Here the material, what is the main material or main element in the capacitance? Conducting plates. Here also, conducting plates. Next, it is independent of charge and potential. These four are the factors where the capacity is independent. The definition itself proves the first two, and these two we are going to prove in the next part. Now we will see one problem based on the capacitance of a capacitor. Cut. Now we are going to watch one problem which is based on the capacitance of a capacitor. See, the problem is written like this. A capacitor connected to a 10 volts battery. It collects a charge of 40 microcoulombs. What is the capacity of a capacitor? Yes, the solution is like this. What are the given things? Potential difference is 10 volts. How much charge it is collecting? 40 microcoulombs means 40 into 10 to the power of minus 6 coulombs. What is the capacitance? What is the capacity of a capacitor? What is the formula of the capacitance of a capacitor or a capacity of a capacitor? C is equal to Q by V. Now substitute. Q is equal to 40 into 10 to the power of minus 6 coulombs. V is equal to 10. 4 times. So 10 volts. Coulomb by V is equal to farad. So 4 into 10 power 6 farad. 10 power minus 6 farad. That means 4 microfarad. This is the capacitance of a capacitor. Next concept is capacitance of a isolated sphere. Now we are going to watch the capacitance or capacity of different spheres. According to the syllabus, isolated and parallel plate capacitor, parallel plate capacitor with dielectric system. These three are very, very important. Next, we will go to the energy concepts and Van de Graaff generator. Let me check what is the capacitance of a isolated sphere. Capacitance of a or of an isolated sphere. Take a sphere of radius capital R. What is the potential due to this charged spherical shell? V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. This is the potential due to this charged spherical shell. What is the capacitance formula? Q by V. So I am bringing this V, which is in the LHS, to the right hand side. So Q by V, this 4 pi epsilon naught R will go to the left hand side. Therefore, 4 pi epsilon naught R is equal to Q by V. This Q by V is capacitance. C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught R. That means capacitance of an isolated sphere is R times the 4 pi epsilon naught. What is this R? Radius. So capacitance of an isolated sphere is R times, R is nothing but radius, times the 4 pi epsilon naught. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 9 into 10 power 9. 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 1 by 9 into 10 to the power of 9. This is the capacitance of an isolated sphere. Next, we are going to discuss about the capacitance or capacity of a parallel plate capacitor in the presence of dielectric medium, in the absence of dielectric medium. Now, we are going to see the capacity of a parallel plate capacitor. Capacity or capacitance of parallel plate capacitor . See the heading, it is a parallel plate capacitor. We didn't mention any medium. That means air is acting as a medium in between the plates. The next case is a dielectric medium is placed between the plates. Let me check what is the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor when air is as a medium. So these are the plates.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.